And welcome back to Basketball Report. So today's just going to be another weekly report, just the classic stuff, players of the week, team of the week, MVP update. Just going to talk about a few things.
And then, upcoming games also
Yeah,
maybe.
upcoming games, games just, standings, just talking about what the week has passed in the NBA and what is to come, just the basic stuff. So without any further ado, let's get into it. That's been a weird week. Weird week in the NBA.
Also, if you look at the, there's not, especially in East, actually,
Yeah, the East
nothing
has been
standing out, actually, nobody, bringing it. And in the West also, actually, it's quite,
yeah, the West has been top heavy, but there's been a few I wouldn't say underdog wins, but unexpected games, teams you would expect to win lost. So it's been really just up and down. Interesting week. There's no team that really solidified themselves as saying like we're taking a step forward. Taking it to the next level has just been all around. So, basically, that's about it in regards to teams. Let's get into our teams of the week. So, starting off with the West, we do have the Los Angeles
We
Clippers.
have the Clippers. We just put them here because they're on a 5-game winning
Yeah,
streak.
5-game winning streak, but also the few good victories against the Lakers, Trailblazers, and Suns. Which is, good games to win for them. A few easy games against the Pistons and Rockets. But, they haven't been fantastic all season. They haven't been, great by all means. And, it's interesting to see what the addition of Cousins is going to have on this team's performance. I really do think it's going to hurt them more. I still do think this team's a pretender. But look, why you are, the better your chances are of making it to the finals. Do I think they can catch the Suns? Maybe not, but third
Maybe
seed.
at first, yeah, I don't think they're going to
I don't know if they're
solidify
third. I
it.
can't see them getting past the third round. First round, to be honest.
Yeah, no,
You're
not
gonna have to
really.
play a team like the Blazers. Okay, maybe win the Blazers, but if they get the Lakers, it's difficult. This team has like a mental barrier.
They're just jokers, let's be honest here.
Yeah, they don't do much. And then
Yeah,
for the East.
we have surprise, surprise, the Hawks, because there's none of the other teams are even performing. So the Hawks are at fourth at the moment, which means actually they're going to go to the next round,
Yeah, most likely. I mean, they
past
had
the
a
first
good week.
round.
Last night they beat the Hornets, and I know the Hornets have also a few injuries, but this team last night they didn't even play their main guys. Didn't play Trae Young, didn't play Collins, didn't play Reddish. A lot of guys missed. So this week, they're 4-1 for the week. They didn't have the most difficult games ever, but they did well. They're on a good run these last couple of weeks. And if they can solidify themselves as the fourth spot, definitely can see them pass get the first round. And might be, I wouldn't say a dark horse necessarily, but definitely a team who can hit you from all angles. I think the Lou Williams trade really, really helps them a lot.
Lou Williams, excellent, six man,
Yeah.
definitely a good point guard. So yeah, but I don't, going to the Hawks, I don't think they're going, maybe going to the first round, but I don't think they have any playoff experience, to be honest,
Yeah,
if you
that's a
look
big
at the
thing. We
team.
still got a young team. Look,
Really young, yeah.
better than last season. This team gives you a lot of scoring, a lot of spacing. They brought in Capella because they wanted a big man. He gives them, good defense, good rebounding. But you can play Gallinari at the five if you want to. You can play Collins at the five if you want to. Look, your options are there. You can go young. You can go small ball. There's a lot of options here. Not a lot of defense, but Hunter, I would say, is probably the best defender from his rookie class. And John Collins has some potential. So look, we're decent. But I think, this team almost like a B-list Nets. A lot of scoring, a lot of options. But at the end of the day, I do think they still need one or two guys just to step up completely. Would be interesting what they see with what they do with the whole John Collins situation. Are we gonna trade him? Gonna give him extension or what going on there? We'll have to see what happens. But I think for now, still a young team, good future ahead of them.
Okay, then we're going to player of the West. For this week, we're giving it to Luka. Had a good week looking at Yeah,
Yeah, I mean,
rebounds and
little
assists,
bit down
sure.
on the free point shooting,
Yeah.
but he takes a lot of free pointers, so you have to also take that into consideration. He's been good. Mavericks have been up and down. Really, they need some consistency. But
Yeah.
you know, as long as they are in the playoffs, I think they could be a difficult team to beat. And you know, this is all about experience. This team is not in their prime yet. They're still putting the pieces together. And you know, making the playoffs is always good for a young team,
No.
for a team with a lot of talent. So you know, this week Luka has been good, putting up good stats. He and Porzingis has been figuring stuff out together, which also increases Porzingis' stats. So you know, we're still working on it. But you
Yeah.
know, all in all, good
Good
week for
product.
Luka.
Yeah, definitely.
Really thought he'd be higher up in all of the people's MVP rankings, but you know, it's fine. We'll pick
It's
up the
still
pace.
a, remember, this team is still not performing. They're seventh
Yeah, we're seventh in the
in the
West now.
West, but yeah. Maybe definitely starting to look like that the overseas guys are bringing it for MVP races.
Yeah, we're seeing
So
it,
yeah.
especially
Then
with
East player of the week, we're giving it to Zach LaVine
once again.
once again. And guy has had a phenomenal week. Looking at his 50 game, his 50-point game, yeah. Looking at that shooting, that's quite impressive.
I
You're almost
mean,
60 and 60 from both.
50-point game, and he only had 8 free throws. That is also something. Made 7 of them. Last night he scored 30, and he made no free throws. So you know, this guy, look, he's doing what he can. He knows he's a lead scorer. His efficiency hasn't been that good this week, but you know, that's something that fluctuates through week in and week out. But he's still been good, still been above average in all the categories. And you know, this guy, really like him. He's got that, I
Yeah,
don't
he
know,
moved
he's,
away from just the dunker and started
I mean,
playing,
really, he's got
the
that.
shooter and, more what he must do a point guard.
Yeah,
So
he feels like a guy when he gets hot. You know, he's insanely hot. He can
yeah.
score from anywhere, he can finish from anywhere. He just needs that support from the rest of the team.
Yeah,
Vucevic has been
Vucevic,
good.
yeah.
He's been very good, but you know, now the problem is, what do you do with Lowry? In terms of point guards, do you go with Thomas Satoransky? Do you
Yeah.
go Kobe White? What's the options? I mean, what you're doing, are you playing Zach LaVine as a shooting guard? Do you want to make him a small forward? Want to go small with Vucevic at the center and Lowry at the power forward, or switch him up? Look, we have to figure stuff out. Billy Donovan, know him good because he's a former Thunder coach, but you know, he'll figure it out. And I really do hope the Bulls can at least make the playoffs this
No, that would be
season,
nice.
even if they lose the first round. I mean, it's fine. It's just showing progress, just showing that they want to improve. And in an easier West, I would expect this team on paper to at least make the playoffs.
Yeah, definitely. Then going through the MVP rankings. So at fifth, we have Luka. As we said, they're starting to figure it out and, definitely moved up. If you wonder why Damian Lillard is not there, just go and check his stats and all the
Yeah,
shots he missed and
it's just
how
been a straight swap.
shit he is. So just go and check it. That's all I can that's
Yeah,
all
I
I
mean,
know.
Luka, put him at fifth here. Okay, there's a lot of guys with injuries.
Yeah.
Kevin Durant has only recently come back. You know, if
Had
he can,
one good game, that's
yeah,
all.
if he can play for the remainder of the season, let's say 20 more games, you know, he'll end the season in about 40 games for the season, you know, then it might be a little bit higher up. But look, Damian Lillard, last night he got 12. I mean, we can pull up his stats here just for reference, just to show everyone
I don't know why he's
that.
overhyped. This guy isn't as good as everybody thinks.
No, no, definitely not. I
So
mean, and look, the Blazers and the Mavericks are like 1 or 2 games behind. So you can't say, okay, oh, but the Mavericks' record isn't good enough to be considered, you know, Luka's MVP. But then
yeah.
they're just 1 game behind. I mean, looking at Damian Lillard's last 5 games, averaging 19, sorry, 17
17
points per
points,
game,
35 from field goal.
35 field goal, and 35 from free. You know, last night, 3 from 10, night before that, 9
Nine
from
from 20. Yeah,
20,
it's just
8 from 21, 2 from 14. And you know, a lot of people giving Russell Westbrook slack for his shooting performances and always comparing him to Damian Lillard.
Yeah,
And
no, I
now
don't know
all
that
of a
coach.
sudden, you know, he's basically shooting worse.
Yeah, so
than,
that's
you
why
know,
he's not even top 10 at the moment.
He's
So
out. For Blazers are doing bad. He's out.
yeah.
If anyone wants to argue, I mean, you can make the case that maybe, you know, I don't know what. You don't have a case, but you can make it.
Yeah, that's no case.
But he's out.
Then at fourth we have Harden.
Also picked up a little injury.
Yeah, a little injury. Don't know actually what's going on there, but you know, I don't think he's going to stay long here because the Nets, I don't think the Nets have the, you know, figured out the way they're going to play. Like they lost against the Lakers, and the Lakers didn't even have LeBron or AD, and they lost like actually
it was a
blowout,
like almost
now,
like 20 points.
And it doesn't make sense for me. I don't know.
Yeah,
how
look,
that happened.
The main thing here is at the end of the day, the Nets have the best record in the East, so you have to put someone at least from the Nets in. James Harden had a good season, good performances. And look, he's still better than Kyrie Irving. So, you know, I don't even want to put Kyrie Irving in the MVP race. But look, the Nets have a lot of things to figure out. For one, defense. For two, how we're going to play. I think there's only like 7 games that all of them played actually together. You know,
Kyrie
and Harden.
Yeah.
Now also taking Aldridge. We played Aldridge at the 5 last night, or against the Lakers, not last night. Blake has been in and out, and then you also have to sit with players like, you know, DeAndre Jordan. What do you do with DeAndre Jordan? So look, they've got big problems, but you know, we'll see. And then three, we've got Joel Embiid.
Made the return and
yeah,
in,
so
the, in our ranking.
He had a good season upon his injury, so
and he's now back and seems like he's, you know, springing it again.
Yeah, I mean, he's not been as good as he was before his injury, but you know, he's starting to pick up. Look, Philly are still second in the East. He can still win MVP if he goes on a good run, if he can stay fit. It's not completely out
but
of the books yet.
You can go and check our previous video. We said the 76ers are pretenders.
Yeah.
So
because they can't stay
fit. They can't stay fit.
They're not gonna stay fit. I can promise you, Joel, he's going to get injury.
Yeah, don't see like if you think about it, when last did you see him beat in the playoffs? I'm thinking about when Kawhi hit that shot over him.
Yeah, I
that's
mean,
the last time I can remember. I know he was in the playoffs last year.
But they got swept.
They got swept, but like,
and
honestly,
last season, I think Ben Simmons was injured.
Yeah, he was injured. Yeah. So
the team can't stay. But even then, when they played the Raptors, you know, the Kawhi shot, he played one game, missed another. Played another game, missed another. You know, if he played all of those games, they would have probably won in 5 or 4. But he missed a lot of games, and that's why, I mean, there's a lot of reasons why they lost. Obviously, the Kawhi shot was a freak. I mean,
it was lucky.
It was lucky, but still, you have to take your shot, and the defense wasn't tight enough. They let him get a shot away, but I mean, that's not the point here.
Yeah, and beat on,
yeah, point
on,
is, this guy can't stay fit in the playoffs.
So, don't think, maybe he stays there, but honestly, don't think he's going to. After, like he was there, but now with his injury after that, I don't think he's going to stay.
Yeah,
that
at
long.
The end of the day, this is MVP, most valuable player. I can't be the most valuable player
he don't play.
If he didn't even play.
Yeah. So then at two, we have Giannis. Maybe some of you guys are going like, why do you put Giannis there? Yeah, look, he must. He's reigning MVP. And, you know, he's injured now. He doesn't play a lot. But hopefully, if he comes back, the Bucks
Haven't struggling, but
they're
look,
struggling.
You can't blame everything on Giannis here. The opportunity was there. If he was fit, you know, but you know, we're making sure that everything's fine.
Yeah.
Still, at the end of the day, yeah, he's missed a couple of games. But look, just because he's missed like 5 games, you're not gonna be like, okay, yeah, but he's not MVP anymore. Look, I mean, KD missed like 20 games. Embiid missed like 15 games. So as soon as Giannis missed more games,
the thing is that if
games,
Giannis comes back, he's at his top performance again.
Yeah,
it's not,
he's still gonna fight. It's not a big injury.
Yeah.
I think it's just with hip not doing too well. And
yeah,
once
no,
again,
I understand,
you know,
this injury.
Still, they still got like a 32-20 record. They're still one of the best teams in the East.
No, third, so Yeah, and then we're going first with Jokic. He's been last week report also there. He's always been in a conversation. And Jokic, okay, they lost against the Celtics
But he still
last
had a
night.
decent game. He
Still,
didn't took a lot of shots.
yeah.
But the thing is about Jokic is his off-ball presence. You know, last night, you know, watching a game, he sets a couple of screens. You know, his movement, he's that link. You know, even if he doesn't get a
Court
lot of
vision,
assists,
a lot
yeah,
of court
even if he
vision.
doesn't get a lot of assists, he puts the guy in a position to be able to score. And he also draws a lot of defenders towards him. You know,
Yeah.
and he's good on switching on the offense. Like you said, court vision, playmaking. This guy can do a lot of things off the ball, even if it's little things just with screens, or you're just being that link up guy for the offense. You know, that's the thing about Jokic. Even if he doesn't have a good scoring game, he still has a big impact on the match.
Yeah.
And that's why he's MVP. You know, take him out of the Nuggets, where would the Nuggets be?
Not even
You know,
playoffs, to be
and that's the
honest.
same argument for Giannis. Look, Giannis missed a couple of games. And the Bucks have been struggling, you know, and they still got a decent team. You know, they still got Middleton, they still got Jrue Holiday. Those are basically almost
Yeah,
all NBA
Lopez.
guys. Lopez, former All-Star. They still got a very decent roster, and they're not winning games. So I know last night they beat the Magic, but still, you know, take a guy out of the team, how do you do? How many games did Joel miss? A lot.
Yeah.
Fella never dropped out of the top two since missing.
Yeah,
Same
so
goes with the Nets. So that's what I'm saying. Take a guy out of the team. Look how the team does, or
yeah.
switch teams. And
And you
that's
see
why,
how valuable he
yeah, that's
actually
why
is for the
Jokic
team.
and Giannis are where they are, top two, because they are so impactful when they play, much more than when Joel or any other guy.
Yeah, so I think that's going to be that.
Yeah.
Please let us know in the comments what you guys think, what's your MVP ranking, we should player of the week, all that stuff. Remember to like and subscribe. And what? Yeah,
Yeah,
catch you.
we've got other links, Spotify, the TikTok,
Pickles, yeah.
Twitter, whatever. And you know, as always, enjoy.
Yeah, away. Oh. Skiria, skiria, skiri,
Okay, we are in the oven or the ear box thing.
papa. Skiria,
Very good.
skiria. The fuck is